Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Michelle Fondon and I'm the author of the new book, Twin Flame Romance, The Journey to Unconditional Love, available now in paperback, Kindle, and Audible books. So go ahead and pick up your copy and buy one for your twin too. If you're currently reading this book and would like to leave a review on Amazon, which is greatly appreciated, please email me at michellefondonauthor@gmail.com once that review is up on Amazon, and I will send you an Audible copy of Chakra Healing for Vibrant Energy, Exploring Your Seven Energy Centers with Mindfulness, Yoga, and Ayurveda. If you're new to my YouTube channel, thank you so much for joining me and all of us today in YouTube land. Please subscribe below to my channel, hit the bell for notifications, give the video a thumbs up, and welcome again. If you would like to schedule a twin flame reading with me, so we've had a little bit of snafus this week in particular. I've been reading for people internationally, so not in the US, but internationally as well, since pretty much the beginning of my video series on twin flames for twin flame readings. And only this week have we had a few snafus really early in the week where people abroad tried to book through the app and they really weren't able to because the app I use through my website can only process in the US if you have a US telephone number. So it's been this crazy thing where it can't happen through this app. I don't know. I've tried to ask the question. I'm not really sure. I haven't gotten a response yet. But the best way to book a reading if you live outside of the United States of America is to email me at michellefondonauthor@gmail.com. If you do live in the US, you can go to fondonwellness.com as well. This is the Twin Flame General Energetic Update, the general reading, the community collective reading for December 8th. Today is Sunday, December 8th through Saturday, and I believe that would be the 15th. I just have to look at my calendar before I start this, you guys. I always just like get all the lighting set up, the camera set up, the chairs set up, everything set up, and then I forget to look at the date. It's very crazy. Before we begin the reading, and if you're new to my readings on YouTube in the community readings, I keep it fairly simple, okay? I get the angel messages, the angel channeling, but as far as the cards go, I know some readers pick like 12 cards, 14 cards, 16 cards, I don't know. I like to keep it fairly simple. If not, I get confused. So I really keep it simple. Generally speaking, two cards for the divine masculine, two cards for the divine feminine, two cards for the collective, so the divine feminines and masculines together as a couple, and then a romance card. It's that simple. But I read the energies as well. So let's start with the divine feminine energies for this week and what I have been feeling for the divine feminine energies. Oh boy, oh boy, for divine feminines. What I've been feeling this week, and it's been a little bit draining, and actually I have purposefully tried not to tune into divine feminine energy for this week because it's been really, I don't even want to say heavy. It's not that it's been heavy as much as it's been angry, if you will. And I'm almost feeling like for the divine feminines, I feel like for some of you have really moved into your personal power and you're living your life no matter what. Like you're living your life, if your divine masculine returns to you or doesn't return to you, you're living your life and moving forward with everything in your life. But for some of you in this collective, instead of moving forward with your life in peace and harmony, what's happening is you're kind of either giving up or moving forward kind of in frustration and anger. And I think it's really that piece of the collective that was really channeling this week. And it was an irritating energy where I was like, I don't even want to post a video. I don't even want to go to YouTube. I don't want to read the comments. I don't want to do anything because I'm really feeling this like divine feminine kind of anger. And it was almost like, I'm going to give up doing YouTube videos on twin flames altogether. Like it was that heavy. It was that much like, what am I doing this for if people are not like moving into their power? And I know that's not true for a majority of you. I know a majority of you are really doing what it takes to stay, not only stay positive, because I'm going to post a video on staying positive because I want you guys to be realistic and tune into your feelings, and that's really important too. I don't believe in blind positivity. I think that's ridiculous. But I think that there is a fair majority of you guys out there who have been almost like jaded. That's the best word, is almost jaded by this experience. And instead of looking at it as a blessing, even if you're not in reunion with your twin, that it has somehow jaded you. And I think intuitively, instinctively, I think that's the wrong way to go. So that was the general feeling for Divine Feminines this week. For the Divine Masculines, the energy that I've been feeling for Divine Masculines this week is actually quite the opposite. It's a really peaceful energy. I'm feeling for the Divine Masculines, it's been generally speaking feeling, I want to say almost the most peaceful that it has been ever for Divine Masculines as an energy. I feel like they're kind of just moving softly through this and just trying to figure it out. They're kind of honestly at the point where they're softly moving through this. Not with too much anxiety, not with too much guilt, not with too much anger, not with too much depression about it. It's just, they're softly, I guess that's the word. So I don't know. Let's just see what the cards say. I'm not really sure how this is going to come out this week. I really don't. I know it's getting close to the holidays. It's getting close to Christmas. As I mentioned in my other videos, the holiday season triggers all sorts of things in people. And it's not just romantic partnerships or relationships. It tends to trigger a lot in childhood memories, expectations, family memories, family expectations, and just family dynamics in general. So try to really stay in your personal power and not let the expectations, positive or negative, of family and holidays and spending holidays with your loved ones or twin or whatever other relationships you happen to be in. Try to be the light in the darkness. Like, really try to be the light in the darkness. So we're going to start with our card pick for the Divine Feminine energy. So dear God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Mother Mary, Archangels, Angels of God, Guardian Angels of all the Divine Feminines in this collective who view this YouTube video, please let this reading be the highest light and love. God the Father, Jesus the Son, the Holy Spirit, let it bring light, love, and truth to everyone involved. Archangel Michael, please stand guard, casting away any lower energies with your sword of light. Please help us with this Divine Feminine energy and what the Divine Feminines really need to know in this collective. Please help them to understand the energy that they have for this coming week in December. Okay, so now I am picking from the Angel Therapy Oracle deck for the Divine Feminines of this week. Divine Feminine energy for this week, December 8th through the 15th. Okay, so now for the Divine Masculines. Let's see where they're at. Divine Masculines, dear angels and guides, please help us to understand the Divine Masculine energy for December 8th through the 15th, 2019. Divine Masculine Collective. Okay, so it looks like I jumped ahead and picked all of the cards magically. That's actually not what happened. What happened was I recorded a beautiful entire video for you guys. And guess what? My camera battery went out. So when I looked at it, instead of having 35 minutes of video, I only had 8. It was rather shocking. And so you may look at that as a message. It might be a message. I don't know. But what it really means, I think, is that my Canon battery is 5 years old and it was just time that I don't think it's holding a charge anymore because it was 3/4 of the way charged when I started the video and it went immediately to 0 in 30 minutes, which should not happen. So, okay, this is the card spread. Even though you didn't see me pick it out, this is actually what it was. I picked an extra romance card for the couple as well. So please bear with me. And I am sorry you missed. This is take two. So let us reveal. And if I don't look that surprised, it's that I've actually already seen the cards because I did the entire video. So I'm just hoping that I can say what was necessary to say to you guys as I channeled the messages. And the messages were really good. I actually got a lot of angel bumps as the messages were going through. So I know that they were angel approved. So let's look at Divine Feminine first. So here's what came up for Divine Feminine. It is the Four of Earth. And remember at the beginning of the video that I was saying how I felt like this energy that was a little bit angry, a little bit jaded for Divine Feminine. And this card really does represent that energy. So the Four of Earth is all about the extremes. I'd say it's the giving and receiving card, but it's really about the extremes. So it's either giving way too much or holding back and not giving it all. So if you look, I love these are fairies. I kept calling them angels, but I really think they're fairies in this deck. On this particular card, they're fairy angels. That's what they are. But if you look at this one, the bigger angel or fairy is very pissed off looking. She looks like really super pissed off. And that is the exact face and energy that I was putting on many of you, not all of you. Remember I said that in the beginning, but many of you in the Divine Feminine Collective, where you're kind of like, I gave and gave and gave and gave and gave. Gave so much of my unconditional love, unconditional affection to my divine masculine, and I'm so sick of it now. I just feel like I gave and gave and gave and gave and gave and didn't receive in return. And now versus, like, it's the other extreme, the opposite, polar opposite side. That's what this card is about. It's about going from one side way to the other side. And I kind of feel that it's sort of going from that extreme giving to extreme, like, not giving to your twin, in the sense of, I am, like, as you see, also she's chained to a pot of gold, but it's sort of like, I'm just gonna, like, think of myself and I'm really jaded right now. I've given too much. I don't want to give anymore. And I'm not happy about it. What I want to portray to you is that when you are at the beginning of your spiritual journey, and it can be really difficult to understand boundary setting and understand balance, because a lot of times those who are nearing the beginning of their spiritual journey, when they're all of a sudden awakened, where you may have been living your life and just not really aware of spirituality in the sense that is to this level of intensity that a twin flame connection causes you to be infused with, just this tremendous amount of awareness of what this is and the spiritual realm that's surrounding you. In the beginning, you really need a long time to grow in spirituality. It's not a thing that happens overnight. Now, for many of us on the twin flame journey, if you're on this journey and you've been awakened and it's been a relatively short period of time, it's like going 0 to 60 in a few seconds. And the thing is, that can be really scary, but it can also leave you with this sense of, like, I'm not really sure how to handle this, nor am I sure how to handle, like, the human aspect of it, or how to really set proper boundaries and not bounce from one extreme to the other extreme. What I'm here to say to you is that the fact that with your twin flame connection, Divine Feminine's experiencing this right now, you made the choice, whether it was like a free conscious choice or not, you still made the choice to give to excessiveness, like at 100%. And you were kind of living in that unconditional love bubble where it's just like, oh, I love the free flow of love and I'm feeling this intensity of love and I want to just give to my divine masculine and just give, and like it's so loving and beautiful and wondrous and amazing. And believe me, I did this too. So it's like so beautiful and wondrous and amazing, and there may not have been a lot of reciprocity on the other side. And that's why I feel that many of you in this collective are really feeling the other extreme in this, like, kind of pissed off fairy. Kind of like this, I'm just done. Like, I'm done with this. I'm done feeling like I'm giving, and not receiving. And it's made me very jaded to the experience. The problem with that is that it's not a balanced approach, if that makes sense. So what we're really striving for is this balanced approach. It's the balanced approach of giving and receiving. It's the balanced approach of setting your boundaries, but being a little flexible, right? And that leads me to, this is manifestation power. That leads me to that. And really what I feel that this is saying is that when you interrupt the flow of giving and receiving, it's really hard to manifest or have your desired outcome come into fruition. It's like the ocean waves, right? You have the ebb and the flow of the ocean waves. When the tide goes further out, that's great. But when it recedes, that's great too. But it can't stay in one of those positions for too long. So if the tide moves outward into the sand and keeps moving outward into the sand, pretty soon you have a disaster called like a tsunami or something. And then if it recedes too much, then the beautiful plant life and animal life that lives in the shallow ends of the ocean, they can't survive. It's this delicate balance, this delicate flow of giving and receiving. And what I feel is that even though you might be feeling depleted right now, Divine Feminines, and you might be feeling a little bit jaded about the whole journey or just about the connection or where this is going, and you really have these intense feelings of, I feel like I gave, didn't receive a lot in return, maybe nothing, maybe very little in return for all the love and flowingness of love that you gave, and now you're feeling that depletion. And you see this, there's a little like naked fairy who were there who gave everything, even the shirt off her back or the dress off her back. She even gave that. And now she's tiny and has nothing to wear. But you still have your desired outcome. So what this Archangel, and I believe this is Archangel Michael or either Archangel, Archangel Michael always has a sword. Archangel Michael here is saying, you still need to focus on your desired outcome. What is your desired outcome, Divine Feminines? Is ultimately your desired outcome to be with your twin? Is that your desired outcome? Or is it to move on? Like, what is your desired outcome? But with the ebb and the flow of manifestation, with the ebb and the flow of giving and receiving, to allow that energy to flow in and flow out, you still need to have some sort of focus on a desired outcome that you really want, that's in your heart space. And so keep the focus on that instead of the jaded anger energy. That's not, I mean, it's okay to be aware, obviously. You want to be aware of your own feelings, but to stay there is probably not the healthier side of things. So let's look at Divine Masculine. So we have for Divine Masculine, we have the Awakening card, which I really, really love. This energy is really beautiful. When I started the reading, I believe I said, and I don't know if it caught this in the first 8 to 9 minutes of video that I actually talked about, I will say it again because it was in the first take that didn't take. So in the first take that may or may not have taken, I don't know, I haven't viewed the footage yet, I did say, before I revealed the cards or pulled the cards, I did say I kind of feel like the Divine Masculine is in kind of a hermit energy. I felt like it was a very soft energy, a soft hermit energy, where I really feel like he's a little bit dormant, but in the sense of re-strategizing his steps, but in a soft way, not in an anxious way, not in an angry way, not in a whatever way, but just a quiet strength of re-strategizing. Now, what I love about the Awakening card is that it's very much similar to that energy. Not so much the hermit, but it is being able to see things from a different perspective. And this is really beautiful. It's the Archangel Gabriel. And of course, the biblical story goes that the Archangel Gabriel announced to the Mother Mary that she was going to bear a child with the name of Jesus, which is the Christmas story. And she, with her golden trumpet, she announced the news. And it's really beautiful because I like the fact that we got this card and it's almost Christmas time. And it's about, but you see the angel's upside down. She's upside down. So she's really starting to look at things from a different perspective. Now, it's a slower moving card. It's a slower moving energy because she's upside down, right? So she can't move very fast if she's upside down, analyzing things from a different perspective. So what I'm seeing this as for divine masculines is that they finally are really seeing things from an upside down perspective, which means if they were saying to their divine feminines, I feel like we're really good friends, but we're not really more than friends. Now they're seeing things from a different perspective and they're going, oh, huh, maybe this connection is more than friends. Or if they were like, oh, this is just a hookup, it's a sexual connection, we have a really strong sexual connection, and that's it. Now they're looking at it from another perspective and they're going, oh, this might be like a longer term connection. So they're really starting, and it's not that they weren't awakened before. I believe that this collective of divine masculines have been awakening. It's been a gradual process, as it is for all of us, maybe slower than for the divine feminines, but it's been a gradual awakening and they've been doing the awakening work, if you will. But now they're kind of having those aha moments. And it's not that they didn't know, that they didn't have feelings for the divine feminine. It's not that either. It's just what I'm seeing is they were compartmentalizing the relationship into a box. And while they knew the strength of the feelings, and while they knew that there was some kind of weird connection, I don't know if they would call it soulmate, twin flames, or other vibe, I don't know. But they knew that there was something weird about it, something else about it. It's not that they didn't know, it's that now what that they're looking at things from a completely different perspective, that they're like, aha, now I get it. Like now I actually get it. Like all the pieces are starting to come together. Like I actually kind of get it now. Whereas before I wasn't really totally putting all the puzzle pieces together. And another thing which I believe is so beautiful about this, so this does indicate divine feminines, if you're listening to this, which I believe many of you are divine feminines, it represents also a pause, a standstill, a pause in action, which is actually okay because it does reflect a re-strategizing, as I had said in the beginning, take one, but it represents a re-strategizing. So it does represent the divine masculines going, okay, now I see things from a different perspective, but I do need to do A, B, C, and D before getting to E. So they're kind of pausing just to re-strategize what they want to do, what they're going to do, which is good. I mean, they're doing things according to the order at which they believe they should be done, which is fantastic. That's a fantastic way of doing things. The other beautiful thing that I said in take one, which I hope I can portray it as well, because I believe it was a really beautiful explanation, and I did get the angel bumps for that one, so I got confirmation, was that this is also about the divine masculines accepting themselves for who they really are in all their weirdness and their quirks. Because for this collective of divine masculines, they really felt that they were weird. And they felt that they were outliers of society, kind of in a way. They may have had mainstream jobs, or maybe they do right now have mainstream jobs, but they felt always different. They felt like an outlier. That's the only word that comes to me, as an outlier. And the problem with your connection, the divine feminine connection with the divine masculine, is that it is a different connection. And when they met you, divine feminines, they felt that you exacerbated their feeling of being weird. And when I say weird, it's that these divine masculines have always been a little more spiritually aware. These divine masculines have been a little bit psychic and intuitive, but they maybe suppressed it and didn't really acknowledge it, or maybe acknowledged it and looked at it as something sort of as like good luck or a hunch of judging people, whether they were good or bad. And so they never really understood this ability to have those hunches and intuitions. And they always felt a little bit weird because of it. And they never really accepted that aspect of themselves. And when they met you, the divine feminine, they were like exacerbated, like this whole thing about I'm weird, I'm an outlier, I'm not normal. In some ways, it was you sort of exacerbated that in them, but in turn they kind of blamed the divine feminine and said like, oh, it's just them, they're pushing me into this connection that's making me feel more like an outlier, that's making me feel more weird. And I don't like the way that feels. It feels just, I've been trying to suppress this feeling of being different, and now it's coming back in my face and I don't like these feelings. I want to feel like I fit in. And so now the beautiful part is they're actually embracing this uniqueness that they are. They're embracing their uniqueness instead of pushing it away, instead of saying like, oh, I'm just an outlier, I'm weird. They're kind of saying like, oh, okay, this is who I am. Like, I get it now. This is who I am. And it doesn't make me weird. It actually makes me unique. And that's really, it's a great transformation to be able to say, you know, my weirdness actually makes me pretty cool. It makes me really unique. And the next one that came up for the Divine Masculines is the ear chakras. And I really love this because this enhances the message of them receiving intuitive messages from their angels and guides. And I've been getting that they've been hearing audibly messages from their angels and guides, and especially in their dreams, especially in their sleep. And if you see this beautiful angel is asleep in a meadow among grass and flowers, and she looks very, very comfy. And when I started the reading, I had said that I felt a soft energy for divine masculines, that they were re-strategizing, doing the work, but I really felt a softer energy. And meaning just a non-aggressive, soft energy. And this message about the ear chakras really enhances that. Like, it's almost like in order to really hear messages, you have to be really quiet and you have to have a more receptive and softer energy to be able to hear those messages. If you're all loud and rowdy and playing music 24/7, like, you can't really hear the messages from your angels and guides. It's just, there's too much noise. So in order to truly hear the messages, you just have to get quiet. And so I believe really that's what's happening with the divine masculines, is that they're seeing things from a new perspective. They're accepting their quirkiness. And they're really receiving these messages through hearing them. I mean, they're hearing them in their dreams. They're really hearing them through their intuition. And it's pretty darn cool. It's like really neat. So let's see for the couple. This is the Six of Earth. And the Six of Earth, I love this. This is about balance. So in the Divine Feminines, we saw the Four of Earth, which is like the extremes, like going to the extremes. And this is about the rebalancing. But I also feel that this is somehow for the divine feminines and masculines. It's about receiving a gift to balance things out. Now, this could be a gift of a promotion, a career change. It could be a sudden inheritance, or it could be just a gift from a family member or friend. Like, I can see like a family member just saying like, oh, here, you know, I just came into some money, or, you know, like, here's $20,000, go have a wedding. Now, it doesn't have to be $20,000, of course, right? Not everybody has $20,000 in their pocket to just give away. Or it's just, I just find this as being like generosity from a third party, leading the twin flames together to be able to recreate that balance between them. And it's just some gesture. I find it's like some gesture of generosity is just like going to come around and honestly just rebalance this energy between the two, and it's just going to be some lucky strike that is somehow rebalancing things and just balancing out that energy of giving and receiving as well. I love this. So this is the God box, and this is about really giving your worries and cares to God and the angels, but physically doing it. I've taken in the past with this is an old Kleenex box, putting God box on it, writing down your heart's desires, your intentions, your manifestation power, right? Your desired outcome, and just putting it inside the box. Then you let it go and you let God and the angels take care of it for you. So it's this really beautiful energy of allowing the divine to help you, allowing the angels to help you with your connection with your twin, and putting your desires, your desired outcome into that God box, and just allowing the beauty of the manifestation to unfold with you and your twin. And it's just this gorgeous, beautiful energy that's just so incredible and so amazing. So let's look at the romance angel messages. So the first one we have here is flirt. And I believe we got this either last week or the week before, maybe. And it's, again, I really find this is about the lighthearted energy, either with your twin, if you guys are in communication, that lightheartedness, that flirtiness, that laughter, joy, fun, just having fun, being lighthearted. But it's also lifting yourself out of that heavier energy, just being able to flirt with life, being flirty with life, enjoying life, having fun, just doing some really cool and flirty and fun things. And it just makes life flow so much easier when you're at that point. And just keep that in mind, especially during this holiday season that can get sometimes a little crazy. So this came up, and this is, so in take one, this is healing family issues. So in take one, my angels had actually guided me to pick a second card from this romance deck right here for you guys. And so I picked the second card, which came up as healing family issues. That is the card that came up. And I feel that it's really super duper appropriate for this holiday season. Now, I understand completely. Not everyone celebrates Christmas. Some people celebrate Hanukkah. Some people celebrate Kwanzaa. Other people celebrate other things during the holiday season. But I'm pretty darn sure that every single country somehow takes some kind of pause, if anything, to go shopping or whatever, but somehow takes a little pause in the month of December to celebrate with family and friends. Now, the problem with that is that there can be a lot of triggers with family and friends that can cause you to go the wrong way emotionally. People can start to push your buttons, and we all have them. In every single family, there are always people that push your buttons or want to push your buttons, or vice versa. It just happens. That's life. And this is a really good opportunity for you to practice your love, compassion, and higher being, really being a higher being for your family, for your friends, being the bigger person, being the bigger example. Now, we do this, guys, with a higher quiet power. It's with a quiet power. It's not with a loud, preachy power. It's just being in your quiet power. And one thing I wanted to emphasize is that, as I mentioned, some of you may have been on a spiritual journey for 20 years already. Maybe it's 10 years, maybe it's 5, maybe it's 2, maybe it's 1. I don't know. What I want to emphasize is that since family issues are always pretty darn triggering for many of us, the angels brought to my attention that when you're on your spiritual journey, it's your journey. It's not anybody else's journey. And
A lot of times when we are seeing things in a new light, when we have this more enlightened view of things and we see things from the grander scheme of things, right? A bigger picture. We see the bigger picture. That it can be really easy to get a little judgy with other people and kind of give them lessons. And here's the thing, is that the people in our lives that come disguised as family and friends, they may not really want to be on the path that you're on. Or maybe they're just not ready to be on the path that you're on. Or maybe they will never be ready in this lifetime to be on the path that you're on. And that's okay, because it's not their time. But as I mentioned, showing them love and compassion through your quiet power is really just being the example. Just be the example. You don't have to say anything. You can say zero, zilch, nothing. And just by your quiet power, you can transform the way people act towards you and react towards you. So it's really about keeping in check just the way you act and react towards your family members. And your twin, obviously. But it really looks like during this holiday season, it truly looks like both of you on both sides, both the divine masculine and the divine feminines, are going to be healing and working through some family issues, which is great. It's a great time to do it. Why not? The holiday times are as good as any to be doing that. And it might be less about confrontation with family members and a lot more about the inner peace about family situations. So you just coming to a general conclusion about certain family issues, just coming to that inner heart space general conclusion and be like, oh yeah, okay. I know what this is now. It's fine. You know, whatever. People are who they are. And that's it. You'll just come to an inner peace about it, which is fantastic. It's a great place to be at. So I hope this was helpful. Make sure, Divine Feminines, that you find your center, find your balance, and that try to honor your feelings, but not necessarily stay prisoner to those negative feelings. Okay, that's really important. Divine Masculines, great job. You're doing a great job. It's great to look at things from a different perspective. It's great to embrace your quirkiness. That's awesome. And for the couple together, be open to gifts of giving and receiving. Be open to rebalancing and making sure you're staying both balanced in your energies. And I think you guys are going to have a really good week. It might go deeper this week than last week. Just go deeper into the depths of who you are, which is fine. So thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for subscribing to my channel below. Hit the bell for notifications. Thank you so much for sharing this video with other twin flames. And thank you guys so much for pledging your support on Patreon, www.patreon.com/Michelle S. Fondon. And I will see you in the next video.